Question I've often been asked is sales a place to get your emotional needs met? I have an ongoing personal debate on this subject. I think on one hand, when you're in a sales situation and you get a snippy or a nasty prospect and you lash back at them, you might feel a little bit better because you didn't take any of their gruff. But did you make the sale? So in a sense, is it a place to get your emotional needs met? No, you put your emotional needs on the shelf. You put them on the side. Unless somebody is, of course, abusive or totally not rational in a conversation. You don't have to let people abuse you. Of course not. But when you're talking to someone, put the personality away. If they say something you don't like or something like that, or there's a little bit of a clash, bottom line is, if you go to the bank and you get a check, a commission check, you get a contract, a deal, another appointment, if that occurs, you win. And sales is all about winning. Now, on the other side, here's where I'm going to get a little controversial. I think you do get your emotional needs met. When I make a sale, see, it depends on what context you're talking about. When you're in a discussion with a new prospect, you're trying to sell them, and there's a culture, commercial, or a ego type of situation. Well, yeah, you can't do tit for tat. You want to make the sale, and sometimes you got to overlook some things, okay? Because that's the bottom line. But when you do make a sale, how good do you feel? And that's the whole point. When you make a sale, when you go to the bank, when your skills, using your skill of words, being a wordsmith, saying the right word, the right story, the right sentence at the right time, using all the different techniques of the gut sales method, redirection, asking questions, stroking, nurturing, empathy, and doing all the things that make sales so wonderful. Can you imagine saying sales is wonderful? You look forward to it. I love talking to people today. It always wasn't like that. But the thing about it is when you make a sale, you're 2 feet above the ground, you're floating, you feel like you're empowered. You feel like no one can ever take it away from you. You have true freedom. See, success is not about the accumulation of wealth and assets and bling bling and stuff like that. It is about the freedom to know that if you lost everything, you had the sense of mind and you were still healthy, you could get back on the phone and start making that 5, 6, 7 figure income all over again because you have the skill set. And that does meet with some of my emotional needs, that I know I can take care of my family, take care of my financial responsibilities, and I can do something I love. So during the conversation with the prospect, sometimes you got to let a few things go. It's about going to the bank and making money. Yes. Okay. And you let a few things slide. Even maybe you don't like the personality and there's a little clash. You let those things go through. You just ignore them sometimes, or you just get back to your guts emotional selling and you make that sale and you feel great about yourself. And then you're egotistical and your emotional needs are met because you are a provider. You are a success story. This is Claude Diamond. Kind of a different little topic there. It comes up very often. I do answer my own phone, 970-281-5151. You can have a free mentoring session with me. Pick my brain. Learn how to do some gut selling. Go to my webpage, clauddiamond.com, and schedule a free 15 minutes with me and give me your hardest stall or objection or what's holding you back in success. Because as I always say, no one deserves success more than you good people. Take care. Thank you.